My brothers and sisters, tonight's dua, you all know it. But many of us do not know what it means and when it should be said. Before I tell you what is that statement is, imagine you open your app, your bank app, and then all of a sudden you see an extra $500,000. Alhamdulillah. You feel very happy, right? It's a treasure that came to you from sources you did not expect. How about a treasure in Jannah? Abu Musa al-Ash'ari radiyallahu anhu, and the hadith is in Bukhari. He said, I was walking and saying, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to me and said, هل أدلك, should I guide you to a kenz, to a treasure from the treasures of Jannah? He said, yes, ya Rasulullah. He said, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله is a treasure in Jannah. What does a treasure in Jannah mean? Just like you were so happy to find that money in your account, the ulama said that ثوابها مدخر لقائلها والعامل بها. The reward, that treasure, is hidden for the one who says it in this dunya and the one who act upon it. What does it mean? Let Ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu explain to us what does لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله mean. He said, there's no way you can stop disobeying Allah without the help of Allah. And there's no way you can obey Allah without the help of Allah. لا حول, حول, تحول, to change from one state to another. There's no way I can change from the state of heedlessness to being guided without saying لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. You want to change from being full of debt to debt free. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. From sickness to health. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. You are single and you want to get married. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. That's why Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم told us, when we are repeating after the muadhin, and when it comes to حيّ على الصلاة, the muadhin is saying, come to the salat. We do not say and say, no, you come to the salat. When he says حيّ على الصلاة, حيّ على الفلاح, we say, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. There's no way I can be able to perform the salat without the help of Allah. So لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, it's a treasure from Jannah. He said to another Sahabi, ألا أدلك على باب من أبواب الجنة? Should I guide you to one of the doors of Jannah? He said, yes, ya Rasulullah. He said, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله is one of the doors of Jannah. Many people say this statement in the wrong time. When somebody tells you your father passed, لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Wrong. When you are hit by a calamity, we always say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. We're supposed to say إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. This is what the Quran taught us. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله is not in this, in that state when you are hit by calamity. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله, when you are weak and you want to become strong, when you are sick and you want to become healthy, you want to change from تحول, change from one state to another, that is what لا حول means. And that cannot happen without the قوة of Allah. We say it when we leave the house, right? بسم الله توكلت على الله ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. The shayateen tell each other, leave this guy alone the whole day. How can you mislead somebody who has been defended, guarded, and guided? These are the secrets of لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Whatever you're going through, dedicate a certain amount for yourself. It doesn't have to be everybody doing the same thing. Whatever you can handle. But make it a habit. Make it one of your adhkar, the daily adhkar. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. May Allah make us from the people who listen and apply لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Say لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله so you can attend Fajr tomorrow in Jama'ah inshallah ta'ala and make a lot of salat on Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.